sharper than any two-edged sword. Listen, why? He made it sharp and powerful. Piercing. Now, why did God say his word was piercing? What the word pierce mean? To do what? Cut.
Yes.
That's the only way you're going to get that lust out.
Amen.
And that pride out.
Amen.
You got to cut with the word of God.
That's right. That's right.
And the word of God said, now you are clean. Oh, I almost feel like preaching now.
Take your time.
Amen.
Come on.
Now you are clean.
Hallelujah.
The only way to get that lust and that filth out, you got to be clean through the word. How shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking on the motion. Glory. By taking heed.
That's right.
According to thy word.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Get this word in you.
Hallelujah.
Listen, we don't have much time left.
No. No.
Amen. And we're in perilous time. Perilous time. Look at what the ISIS are trying to do. They are discovering that that plane, that Russian plane that crashed, they're discovering there was a bomb planted on it that brought that plane down. I might have would have flew up there, up to New York, but when that plane fell with them 224, I told my wife, no ma'am, no ma'am, no ma'am, I'm not flying to New York. Amen. Now, next time I fly, I'm going to be flying away from here. I don't want to be in no airplane. Yeah. So what you scared? No, I just sometimes I feel a phobia, a claustrophobia. I get inside, you know, like everything want to come in. So
I
in the part that I ain't got to fly. For 10 years we've been traveling without flying.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I don't know why, but most of the preachers that I talk to, especially kind of my age or less than
it's
me,
true.
Most of them say, no, I ain't flying.
That's right. Amen.
I ain't flying.
Amen.
But you don't know with those terrorists that's getting into our country. Now, I believe they're suspicious that somebody at that airport, that worked at that airport, got that bomb on that plane.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right. The inside job.
Was suicidal, took the airplane and ran it into the mountain, killed all those folks. That his co-pilot was trying his best to get into the car, and he couldn't get in because he had locked the door. Amen. Jesus. He had seen the other part. He was purpose in his heart to crash that airplane.
Amen.
Amen. That's when you would have been on it. Yeah, we're saved. Yeah. And we got sense too.
Amen.
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 So if I feel that it's a possibility that I can't put over to the side and part and get out, I don't need to be in it. Amen. Amen.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Yeah. But you say yes, ma'am.
That's right.
I'm sane and sensible.
Thank you, Jesus.
I leave them that to them that's bold. I ain't got that bold yet. Amen. But I'm my boldness is like Stephen's.
Talk about it.
Amen. And that's how we as preachers got to be.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on.
In Acts 21:29. You know what they did? No, 21:53 in the book of Acts. This is how we got to use that word that God just said is quick and powerful and sharper, piercing. Stephen said some word that pierced them to their heart. And you know what they did to Stephen? Stoned him.
Yes, Lord.
That's how we got to be. Amen. We can't be afraid to preach against these homosexuals.
That's right. That's right.
And these folks and all these sex sins.
Amen.
We cannot be afraid to do it.
No, sir.
But Paul said, if I seek to please men, I'm no longer the servant of Christ.
Our Lord Jesus.
We cannot be scared to preach against sin.
That's right.
Because sometimes the Paul said, how can they hear without a preacher? So we don't preach against what they are doing. Some of them won't know it's wrong.
Amen.
That young man told her, what are you talking about? He's talking about the Lord said, man, I love, my wife loves me to do a sin. And he wasn't ashamed to say that.
Amen.
It's what they doing say. Ashamed of.
That's what they say.
But how can they hear?
That's right.
If we don't preach against oral sex, some folks won't know. They think it's all right because you're married.
Amen. Amen.
And they go to the scripture. So the word of God said, you know, marriage is honorable in all.
Uh-huh.
And the bed is undefiled. But what you think is going on when you go to doing all these ungodly, unclean acts in the bed, you have defiled that bed.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. No, 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 no. You could give me all the money in the city of Chicago or all the money in New York.
Amen.
Then do that kind of mess on my wife.
Go ahead, so preacher.
It's quiet now.
Go ahead, preacher.
I didn't marry my wife.
That's right.
She didn't marry me for that. It's getting quiet in here.
Go ahead, preacher. Hallelujah.
You ain't got no business doing oral sex.
That's right.
Revelation 22:15 said, but thou art dog. Now, what's the nature of a dog?
That's right.
The first thing he want to do when he see that other dog is run up behind
him. Yes, sir.
Amen.
And go to cat licking.
Amen.
Take your time.
Amen.
It's getting quiet.
Amen.
When Stephen was preaching, they got so quiet, they got so mad, they stoned him.
That's right.
Why? Because he was saying something they didn't want to hear.
That's right. Amen.
keep your church clean. You got to clean it up with the word.
That's right. Amen.
We ain't got no business with folks practicing all say, send them out our ministry.
Amen.
Jesus.
And masturbating either.
Amen.
You, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
No, you ain't got no business folks sitting up here playing with themselves.
Mm.
Masturbating.
Jesus.
Fulfilled. But all you got to do is take that word and hide it in your heart like David said and let that word
clean.
Modify
that's you. Right.
Amen.
I left out the world in 1961.
Thank you, Lord.
1961. Amen. Amen. And I was the devil in St. Louis. Amen. I don't mind telling you, I was a drug dealer and a drug user.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Right. Share it.
Month of October 1961, I walked off the street. My daddy called me and told me to meet him in Cairo. I met him in Cairo, Illinois. Amen. And listen to me, and I wouldn't stand up in the pulpit and tell a lie. I didn't touch another woman. And I didn't touch myself.
Thank you, Lord.
God gave me a wife.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That's right.
My wife
He's
died.
A keeper.
We had been together a little over 40 years. Never hit her. Never had a fight.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
And the Lord took her and he gave me another virgin.
Thank you, Lord.
Both my wife were virgins.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because at one time in Chicago, I had a church full of virgins.
Come on with it.
Mm.
Wow. Amen. My wife, Mother Laura, she was 36, 32 when I married her. And Mr. Mitch was 36 when I married her.
Mm.
And I haven't touched another woman since I've been married to her.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Not another one. And you have to add this now, and no man either.
That's right, that's right.
I ain't no sissy.
Glory to God.
You have to add that. Now these times, glory to God, these are the thing that gets in the spirit of people.
Amen.
It ain't one thing gonna get it out. Cry loud.
That's right.
Spare not.
Spare not.
Get
hallelujah.
Voice.
Hallelujah.
Like a trumpet. Show my people. Show them it's a sin to
that's
commit
right.
oral sex. Even
tell
if
it.
You're married.
Tell
show them it's a sin
tell
to
it.
Masturbate.
Tell
show
it.
Them it's a sin to
tell
smoke
it.
Loud.
Hallelujah.
Show them it's a sin.
Amen.
To miss serving when you could have been there.
Hallelujah. Tell it.
She said the setup, what you said was on Wednesday, simple.
Empire.
Tell it.
Say what's going on. You sitting up watching Empire.
Amen.
No.
My Lord.
Do you know the church that God is coming for?
Clean.
It's going to be a church. Galatians 5. I mean, 1 Thessalonians 5, 26.
That he might sanctify.
That's the kind of church that he's coming for. He sanctified himself. That we carry, glory, that we all might be sanctified.
Thank you, Lord.
Through the truth.
Thank you, Lord.
That he might present it to himself. A glorious church means an honorable church, a respectable church. That's the kind of church he's coming from. Without
not having spot.
You can't. Don't leave here with spotted up.
That's right.
Sin.
That's right. Not even one.
And I heard the preacher say the other night, man, you ain't got no business still cussing.
Amen.
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 Ooh, I didn't mean to say that. If it wasn't in there, it wouldn't have come out.
That's right. That's right.
No, but sugar, honey, iced tea. Cussing on the slide.
Uh-huh. Tell the truth.
Amen. Amen. You know what sugar, honey, iced tea means? You know what that abbreviate, don't you?
Uh-huh.
Except you're still letting it slip. Amen.
Tell the truth.
It's in you.
Yeah.
You know why it's in you? You haven't been taking that word.
Amen.
Amen.
That he might present it to himself.
A glorious church.
The word that the preacher preached will clean that stuff out of your spirit. It'll get it out of you.
Yes, it will.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't know. I guess it's permissible for me to say this. You know, there's some teaching now that's existing that used to didn't be back in the days of the old schools. There ain't nobody perfect.
Mm. Amen.
Big lie.
Nobody's perfect.
Hmm.
When we used to use that teaching and that preaching against them sectarian churches, they were snuff dipping and tobacco chewing and whiskey drinking and calling themselves Christians. Because they are preachers who say nobody's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
But I know what the word says.
That's right. He therefore perfect.
And I preached this in Milwaukee. And I said that's going to not hurt certain things I preached. And I told them this. If I didn't think I can be perfected, what's the use of me striving to live?
That's right. Amen. Amen.
What's the use of me suffering to live?
That's right.
Sin if I can't be perfected.
Amen.
Colossians 1:28, whom we preach, warning every man, teaching every man in all wisdom, that we might present every man how? Perfect.
Amen.
In Christ Jesus.
God the only way.
Abraham when he was 99 years old in Genesis 17:1, Abraham, walk up before me and be thou perfect.
That's right.
God told the devil in Job 1:8, have you considered my servant Job a perfect and upright man?
Hallelujah.
One that feared God and eschews evil. Have you considered him?
That's right. Consider him. Jesus.
And God said in Matthew 5:48, God don't make no mistakes.
That's right.
Be ye therefore
perfect.
Perfect.
You know what they're saying now?
And they're looking at these theologians. They're getting these things from these theologians. But they tell me they preach the gospel with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven. They saying now that perfect only means mature. It only means mature.
Uh-huh.
They're trying to nullify the holiness part of it.
Amen.
And we're not going to stand for that.
Amen.
No, because this word that we preach, it'll cleanse you from all sin.
Amen. Amen.
Sin.
Hallelujah.
Don't let the devil deceive you.
Thank
there ain't
Jesus.
Nobody living perfect.
Thank you,
there
Lord.
Ain't nobody perfect. Ain't nobody going to be saved.
That's right. Might as well close your Bible.
Yes, you can be perfect.
Amen.
Why? How you know? Because God said so.
God says so.
Whom we preach, warning every man, teaching every man in all wisdom, Jesus. That we might present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. Perfect.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, if he said in Matthew 5:48, be ye therefore perfect, even as your heavenly Father is perfect. You know what the word even means? The same.
Same.
The same as your heavenly
same
Father
as.
Is perfect. Well, let me use that word that they say it means mature. Now, if I'm going to be as mature as God, I'm still perfect.
Amen. Amen.
If you want to change the word, it means mature.
The word got you.
Then he said, be ye therefore mature, even as your heavenly Father is mature. Was God perfect?
Yes.
Was he perfect?
Yes, he is.
Well, we got to be perfect.
Amen.
Even as our Father, which is in heaven. And if I didn't believe it, I wouldn't be striving to live free from sin the way I do.
Amen.
I mean, I keep sin out of me. Why, Bishop? Because 1 John 3:8 said, he that commits sin is of the devil. And the devil sinned from the beginning. For this call the Son of God was manifested to take away.
Hallelujah.
To take away the sin.
In Jesus.
If he that commits sin is of the devil. That's what the word
says.
He that commits sin is of the devil.
That's right. It's his Father.
Take your time.
And Jesus came to deliver us from sin.
Amen.
Children, don't let the devil fool you.
Amen.
You're going to have to be perfect if you want to go to heaven.
That's right. Amen.
God throw the devil out of heaven, and he don't intend for sin to ever get back in heaven anymore.
Amen.
That's when he said that he might present it to him, said, glory.
Amen.
That he might present it to himself.
Yes, Lord.
A glorious
amen.
Church. What's going to make you so glorious and honorable?
Not having spot.
It's not. The church that goes back with the Lord when he comes in the rapture is not going to have a spot.
Or
it's not going to have any wrinkles.
Or any such
it's
thing.
It's not going to have any such thing that look like sin.
Amen.
But that is what?
But that it should be holy.
Holy. You know the thing that's holy doesn't have any sin in it.
That's right.
As long as it got sin in it, it's not holy. Amen.
Amen.
Don't let the devil fool you.
That's right.
That's what they was in sectarian churches were teaching and preaching back then in the days of old, that nobody's perfect.
Amen.
And that's when they kept all that mess going on in the
church. Amen.
Because if you can't be perfect, what's the use of suffering to keep from sinning?
Amen.
You can't help but to sin, then nobody's going to be saved. That church that he coming for, it's going to be without a spot.
That's right.
Wrinkle.
Or any such thing.
Or any such thing.
But that it should be holy.
You know, I guess age must be getting the best of me. Sometimes I get to preaching and talking about sin. I forget that I ain't at home. See, at home, I sometimes preach 3 and 4 hours.
You're home. You're home.
Amen.
You are home.
And I'll be sure. Did I be sure that I get a thorough good job done?
Amen. Make yourself
amen.
At home.
I'll be sure. And not only that, I'll be sure that they have an understanding. Because what I tell them, read.
That's right.
Read.
Get your Bible.
Then I give them an understanding. Because God said, I will give you pastors according to my heart. Jeremiah 3:15.
Amen.
Who shall feed you. Knowledge.
Hallelujah.
And understanding.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. God wants some real saints.
Amen.
Perfect saints.
Amen.
That's the kind of saints he
amen.
Wants. Because he said in John 1:47, he said, when he saw the coming, he said, behold, and Nathan, he said, behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom there is no guile.
Thank you, Lord.
No deceit.
Amen.
Nothing but honesty and truth.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, if you're ever in the city of Chicago, amen, stop by.
Amen.
Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Friday night, or Sunday.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen. You may have to bring your pillow because sometimes we don't get out till 1 or 2 o'clock.
Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
But I have saints that testify to live in freedom and sin.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. We got a young lady getting ready to get married next month.
Oh, glory to God.
Amen. She's been under me 22 years. Never had to confess.
Thank you, Lord.
Of anybody touching her.
Thank you, Jesus.
We got another one 67 years old. Counted to us when she was 19 and she's still a virgin.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. And got others there that are virgin. Because I teach them, you ain't got no business, no man got in the business touching you.
Thank you, Jesus.
In an ungodly way. Yes, unless Lord. He's your husband.
Yes, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. And I pound that in them. You ain't got no business. In the time of man, the fool, you let him fool with you, and he's not your husband. That man just made a whore out of you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
He just made a whore out of you.
Amen.
And there shall be no whore of the daughters of Zion.
Thank you,
nor
Jesus.
Nor sodomite among the sons of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
God doesn't want a sissy or a whore in his church.
Amen.
And you
Amen.
Thank God because your husband can be saved.
Amen.
Your wife can be saved.
Thank you, Lord.
As I close, I'm going to quote what Paul told the church in the 7th chapter book of 1 Corinthians concerning the things you wrote under me. See, they wrote Paul being inquisitive. They want, let me quote it. I'll be more brief in the quoting. Concerning the things that you wrote unto me. See, they requested some information from Paul.
Mm-hmm.
He says, it's good for a man not to touch
Amen.
A woman. Stop touching, it won't be nothing else.
Amen. That's true. Mm.
Most fornication starts by touching and feeling.
Amen.
Make him keep his hands off of you.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
You talk with your mouth, not your hand.
Thank you, Lord.
He ain't got a bit of feeling and rubbing on you.
Thank you, Jesus.
The next thing you know, there's going to be some fire burning.
Amen. Amen.
And I'm not talking about the kind of fire coming from a match. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Concerning the thing you wrote unto me, it's good for a man not to touch a woman. But nevertheless, to avoid fornication.
To avoid it.
That he,
hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That every man have his own wife.
His own.
And every woman have her own.
Yes, Lord.
And if you don't have a husband or wife, you
wait
don't
on
have
the Lord.
Nothing in nobody.
That's right. Wait on the Lord.
Walgreens, Walmart. They're coming up with sex toys now.
My Lord.
And you'd be surprised at the young women that's buying these sex toys.
Jesus, my Lord.
For gratification. And hell gonna be there open.
Amen.
Because God had an intent for you to have sex, he would have given you a husband.
Amen.
Or a wife.
Amen.
And those are the only ones that's supposed to be having sex.
Amen.
Amen. If you ever in the city of Chicago, 7208 South Ashland.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
You'll be more than welcome. And if you want to hear holiness, you're going to hear true holiness.
Thank you, Lord.
Then if you don't want to hear true holiness, keep on going.
Keep on moving. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. The God told the preacher, you better cry loud.
Cry loud.
2 weeks ago, son of man, I made you a watchman unto the house of Israel. When I said to the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou give him not warning, the same wicked man or woman gonna die in their sin.
My Lord.
But their power, but their blood is gonna be required at your hand.
Jesus, Jesus.
A couple of Saturdays ago, the saints came up from down south to the church. And God just, I don't know, like the power of God overtook me. And I just started preaching.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. And just stood there just about in one spot. Mm. Amen. Why God was breaking those yokes. The deacon Allen told me, he said, Bishop, look like God got in you. Time! Look like God got in you. Got in your head.
Jesus.
He said, it looked like he was trying your best to be sure there wasn't no blood
Jesus.
In your head.
Jesus.
That's how we got to preach it.
Amen.
Because if we don't preach it to you and you die in your sins, your blood
is on your hands.
It's going to be required at our hands.
My Lord Jesus.
So don't get mad with me.
Amen.
Pastor,
thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
About your sins. Amen. Be glad that he's doing it.
Amen.
That's your only
hope. Save your soul.
How can they hear?
Without a preacher.
Without a preacher.
Amen.
That's the only way you're going to hear.
That's right.
And then how can you straighten up and get right if you don't know what's wrong?
Amen.
He got to cry loud. Spare not. Amen. Amen. Like, not too long ago, this one of the saints got rebuked about something.
Yeah.
And I told him, say, you better not, I dare you to be petting her. Mm. I'll rebuke her and you're going to be smooth talking and petting her. No, you into a whooping yourself.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
No, you don't need no, you going to whoop a child in cat, and then after a while, pet the child. You're
Amen.
Not helping that child
That's
at all.
That's right. Amen.
Matter of fact, you're making it worse.
Making it worse. Amen. Tell the truth.
When the pastor rebuke you and reprove you, you don't need petting. Amen. If you don't say anything to him, the pastor's right.
That's right.
The pastor's right.
That's right. That's you're what wrong. You say. Amen.
Now God bless you. That's it.
God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
If you ever in Kickville, Lord, what's that, girl? Vote that vote.
10th Street.
10th Street. 10th Street.